What is going on, guys? Wiser here, coming to you with recap of one of the most recent wars for Invicta. It was a random matchup against the fine ladies and gentlemen over at WHF. Wiz on her face. Obviously, Powerbang and his crew are a bunch of stand-up individuals over there. So it was a crazy matchup, especially Invicta just came off a heartbreaking war versus 1.0. Came down to percentage. We did have quite a few 2.0, I think like six probably 2.0 guys over for that war. It was a missed arranged matchup. So all those 2.0 guys obviously went back to 2.0. Invicta had filled their roster up actually with a few new swarm members. So definitely a lot of, overall, I'd say actually in Invicta, probably I think in this war specifically, we had 9 members that have been in Invicta for I'd say 2 weeks or less. 3 of them in this war happen to have their very first war with Invicta against WHF, so that was crazy as well. Let's just hop on over. We're going to check out the result. 82-77 for WHF, so obviously a commanding 5-star victory for those guys. We'll just go a few details about the war, right? When we matched up, you can see we have a 4th Town Hall 11 there. They only had 3. Now, Invicta, not too long ago, matched up against WHF 2. I'm not sure if that's just their sister clan or their training clan. I don't know how it works like Invicta, but they had a substantial advantage. So they reached out to Invicta leadership and offered to even up the grounds and have one of their 11s act as a 10. So we figured we should probably give, especially the main clan, the same respect. And we reached out to PB and asked them what we thought and kind of came to some agreements. Robots here ended up putting his warden and eagle outside the base and did not use his warden for both his attacks. So trying to even it up a little bit, show that respect right back. So hope that was appreciated over there, WHF, especially because, Invicta in general is not our main clan. It's our training clan. In fact, I'd say Invicta's actual title of a clan is our arranged war training clan. Now, at the same token, like I just mentioned, let's just go down the list here and check out some things. Igba, this was his first war ever with Invicta. Same with Junior, both their first wars, very maxed out Town Hall 9s. Who else we got? Victor has only been in the clan for a couple weeks. Val has only been in the clan for a couple weeks. Zojo, this was his first war with Invicta as well. So there's those 3 guys. Schizo's only been in the clan for a couple weeks. Zeus has only been in the clan for a couple weeks. Eris has only been in the clan for a couple weeks. Silent has only been in the clan for a couple weeks. So a lot of very new swarmies coming up. And I wanted to express, even though the score doesn't fully dictate that, we had some really good successes considering half of our Town Hall 9s were very, very new, if not first war members with Invicta. We still forced a couple bullies, and against a clan like WHF, I think that is a big success in just itself. We did struggle a lot in the 9s. That's where we lost the war. Again, no one's fault specifically, but when you have that many new members in a clan, obviously, you go up against some veterans like WHF, right? I mean, they performed as we expected versus one of our training clans. So good job over there, WHF. I mean, you kind of held up to your side of what we thought was going to happen, that's for sure. But, Invicta, grats, you put up a hell of a fight, I will say. We limited them to only 1 TH10 3-star. I guess, I know Powerbang just did a video about Caps, the 6-star or 6-pack hero or whatever you want to call it, but he didn't actually have a 6-pack. He had a 5.99 pack, I guess. So I don't know, maybe we'll call Caps the almost 6-pack hero, because that's that was the case here. No offense, Caps, but I don't know, just thought that was kind of strange. 99% or not, it's still not a 3-star, unfortunately. Very near miss. But you can see as we flip over to this side, right, missed an 11 up there, so that is tough. Did not have any TH10 versus TH10 threes, although we had a couple bullies down there that kind of even things up. And you look at those 2 3-stars there, if we had just cleaned up the 9s, we would have been in the running. But had a lot of struggles down there. A lot of newer attackers getting used to our system and so on. And, you know, had some late attacks, more late than we're used to. And, you know, not making excuses, but definitely a tough, tough war for a training clan overall. So is what it is. And on top of it, right, we tried to even up the playing field for them. So, again, all good fun, good stuff. We had to use way more bullies than we hoped. In fact, let's just take a look. I think WHF had 3 bullies. I mean, this one is a 9.5, so you can't, whatever, call that whatever you want, but definitely Igba got bullied. And if you go all the way down to number 30, Mr. PB himself had to dip down to number 30 and clean up silent there so they could have a clean board on the 9. So definitely some successes. I mean, another point I'd like to make is we did just come off that 1.0 war. Well, Kadok and the 2.0 base building team literally threw together probably 15 to 20 bases for guys to use. Really, really put forth an insane base building effort for that war, and then immediately came over to this war. So now a lot of expectation was on our Invicta guys to rebuild, and you know, they did a really good job. Everyone was submitting bases. Everyone was pulling their own weight. Had a lot of really nice base designs in there, I think, overall. Kind of sucks because I guess Powerbang did a stream recap where he showed every single one of our Town Hall 9s get 3-starred. So that kind of sucks, especially since it's a main clan versus a training clan. But is what it is. You know, it's all in good content. I understand. You know, plus he showed both caps his hits on our 10s, the 99%, and then his 3-star. So pretty much all of our bases minus 7 of them were shown publicly, which kind of sucks for our base building team. But our guys love base building, and I think that's why they're really good at it, because they got no problems pumping out some new bases. So is what it is, guys. Hopefully public can enjoy some of those sexy base building designs by our guys over there. As you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 Town Hall 9s were missed on our part. And that is with, like, we had to use way more bullies than them. I think we used 6 bullies and still left 5 on the board. So, like I said, we struggled. I think we only had about 10 or 11 9 versus 9 3-stars, which is a very, very low rate than what Invicta is used to. But no one's fault. I mean, you go up against some tough guys like this, and it's bound to happen. So, anyhow, I do have quite a few replays here I do want to show you. So we're just going to start right from the bottom and jump right into it. So let me do this. Get a little recap juice going and let's do a recap. Number 30, Matchness here. Had very sexy 6-pack this war. Jumping in. Checking this hit out. So 5 Valkyries here. Brings a little bit of a queen walk. Apologize, I might be a little rusty on some of these. I watched them earlier today, and I just got home from work, and I'm kind of just jumping back into it. So yeah, hopefully I remember these pretty good. But Match goes right at this Queen Chamber here. What I liked about this was takes out the high hit point buildings with only the cannon. The Queen doesn't even aggro him here. Second cannon does lock on, but it doesn't matter. Queen still has not locked on, so right, perfect timing on that poison. Slows that rate of fire. Doesn't need to use the ability, doesn't need to use any sort of rage, finishes that off, takes the cannons out. Her job is pretty much done. Just gonna finish off these cannons, start working up through all of this trash, I believe at 3 o'clock, and then pull out the clan castle here in a moment. Probably just times 2 this. I got a lot of replays that I definitely want to burn through here. Okay, so yeah, so here comes that giant. Just going to take out that cannon, then drop a golem here. Needed to get rid of that cannon so he could cleanly drop this golem on that wall. Really tough to make that funnel sometimes when you only bring that cold-blooded golem. I've talked about that before. So funneling wizards down kind of at the 9 o'clock. Army camp's done, so perfect. Just got to start working on that gold storage because that's the only building left on the outside of the base over here. Like, look how lacking it is for buildings over here. Just super easy to create a funnel. Wall's going to open up. He's going to let these 5 Valkyries in with this king. Jump spell, I believe, is going to go over this intersection to let everything up into the base. I was watching this before, and I don't know if this was a cleanup. So there goes that clan castle. It's a golem going over that queen. Not going to be a big deal at all for her to deal with. But I was watching this, like I was saying, and I think I might have placed the jump here. Because you would have led into this very large, long compartment. I don't know, just a thought. How do you critique a 3-star, though?
takes out that bomb just before the hogs get there. The hogs are going to just do some work, helping those tanking units out, ripping through those defenses like nothing. Hogs are all in from the bottom section here. Heal spell down right over top of that bomb. Just going to work through these defenses. The few hogs he sent in up the top are now meeting up in the center here, and it's definitely GG for this base. Tree in the bag. Nice job, match. Matchness. I always wonder if I'm saying people's names correctly. All right, so 27, my man Heartless. Bring in very similar attack. Or maybe this is the attack with no golem. Yeah, this is the attack with no golem, I'm pretty sure. So just going to go ahead and drop this queen down with these healers. Take out all this trash. Down goes the one giant. Couple wizards taking out those buildings. Creates this, this huge funnel all on the outside. Then he even drops more giants on the outside on this mortar here, actually. Drops these other two giants here in a moment on the there they go. Drops another wizard behind. Just like, look at this huge funnel he's created. Basically almost all the way from 9 to 3, pretty much. So the idea here is he's gonna let his queen into this compartment. And then literally just drop the Valkyries on the wall by themselves with the king and bust into this compartment and jump over the queen. It's absolutely crazy, like the planning. Look at this. Boom. Valkyries go down. It's like, oh, well, we're just going to shred through this wall like absolutely nothing. They lock onto the king there for a second. No big deal. Queen's under rage now over there dealing with those clan castle troops like nothing. Bunch of wizards, bunch of archers, right? Poison goes down. I'm going to take care of those immediately. Valkyries are in doing work, right? Pest Tesla farms down. Expos down. Just working through this base. Here goes that jump right in the queen chamber. They're about to lock on. Early heal spell there, right? Just to take care of them as best as he can. I was looking at this too. Like, look at this jump. Let's zoom in on this jump. Look at this jump. It's like right on this tile, but somehow the units jumped out of this tile, not even under raids. Like, that is a whole space and a bit, I would say, to get out there. Kind of interesting, but whatever. These Valkyries kind of wanted to go outside anyways, because if you look over here, Queen still has all her healers working in on this stuff. The only thing targeting her is the mortar and the expo. She's going to work through that. Hogs are now in. There's just not enough defenses left to handle these troops here. Absolutely smashed it. Nice job, Heartless. Oh yeah, this is a swag poison, swag wall breaker, swag hogs. Didn't even need to send in those hogs on the back end. Very, very nice. Tree in the bag, my man Heartless. 26, Zojo, brand new member, very first war in Invicta. Welcome, my friends. This is your first recap. So I'm trying to remember this attack on the fly here. Just kind of throws, I believe, everything at this queen chamber. Poison down on both heroes, so that is beautiful, right? Only one golem's been deployed. Queen goes down, double wizards, right? Just taking out all that high hit point stuff as quickly as possible. Wall gets open up now. Golem goes in, king goes in. Valkyries are about to go behind. He's just waiting for that storage to go down. Down it goes. Here comes the CC of Valks. The other Valks in behind. Poison spell goes down. Gonna start taking care of those CC troops. Kind of scary for a moment because the queen's stuck on the outside, but does have that wizard in there that really, really, really helps out. There's two wizards, my bad. So balloon goes down, so that's perfect. They start working on that dragon a little bit. Poison's gonna finish that off, no problem. Valkyries are in there doing work. Immediately drops these hogs in this little Tesla farm with a heal spell over there. Takes care of that section of the base. Really just needs to worry about this wizard tower farm now and kind of this bottom section of the base, but still has 15 hogs, a giant, and a heal spell. Obviously, if you look at this at this point, now that these hogs have been successful over here, there doesn't stand a lot of chance for this base because there's only like 3 compartments worth of any sort of threat. And if you look over here, there's the cannon, 2 archer towers, right, and a bunch of splash. All the hogs are now starting to get feeded in. The wizard tower does a little bit of damage. You know, he does lose quite a few hogs because here goes this bomb. So loses that pack, sends in the rest of this last compartment. Just working through all these defenses one at a time. Now got all these Valkyries and the queen in there doing work. Definitely doesn't stand a chance for this base. Drops a giant and a hog on that mortar on the back end. See you later. Tree in the bag for Zoj. Welcome to Invicta, buddy. Match again. Nice six pack, my friends. I definitely want to show this one. You know, I'm always talking about these open alleyway bases. I'm actually kind of surprised, too. Powerbang did a video about these dead zone bases, and the same sort of theory applies about what he was talking about, is that it just sections your base off too much in the sense of, yeah, this queen chamber, it takes quite a bit to bust through it. But if you look, not a lot, right? He just suicided his heroes right in there with a few Valkyries. Poisons the CC troops, doesn't even drop his queen. Here's what I thought was crazy. If you just drop the queen would be in there under rage, ripping those CC troops out. Instead, I don't know if he forgot his queen. I don't know if this must have been planned. Because if you look, there's not a lot of defenses, right? Like the queen immediately takes out the point defense, does her thing over here. I don't know why he... I don't know why he... didn't think that this might be a problem, but the healers are, it wasn't a problem, right? Like the healers are keeping, they're really hurt. Don't get me wrong. Everything kind of finishes off right here. But they kept them alive long enough to rip this huge chamber apart. Queen suicides this whole chamber by herself, comes in and steps up and finishes off the dragon just in time. And here come the hounds. Two hounds in on this air defense. Like if you look at the way this little box is set up, it does not stand a chance against an air attack. That like 50% of the base is gone. This half is gone. All he needs to do is have the air attack for 1, 2, 3 air defense. Just super easy deployment. 3 rage spells covers the entire box. This base is done for, clearly. Boom, boom, boom. And just got to make it over to this last compartment, which didn't get the wizard tower. So look at this. This looks a little scary for a moment, but we're fine. Smashed it. Nice six pack, my friend. Another tree star in the bag. Good old King of the North had to take a bully, but we got Valen Frenze, a very new member. Actually, we've been very impressed with Val. We just kind of are getting him involved in our Spec Ops team. Does a lot for the clan. Planning wise, came up through Swarm, just really been impressive for us the whole way along. So welcome, buddy. Think you've been on recaps before, but regardless, thought we should mention that recognition. Poison spell goes down right over that queen. I love how the guys are using that. Like you just do not need to spell it. Like the one spell space is really all you need, especially when you have fairly even heroes like that. If you have a level 10 queen going against a 30 queen, yeah, you might want to reconsider. But when you got even queens like that, you just drop the poison. Healers are going to keep her up, no problem. One thing you do need to note, though, you need to make sure she's not working on trash buildings, because if she's taking damage and working on trash and the queen steps up and starts firing, the poison might not be enough if you don't get it down early enough. Anyhow, other poison spell goes down. Going to take care of that drag whiz, all that jazz. Like nothing. Queen's going to finish things off over here. So defensive queen down, CC troops taken care of, and we are going to commence with the next section of the attack. Funneling wizards are down. Giant goes down to help tank for them. Another giant goes down, and wall breakers are in, letting these Valkyries right in the base. Just perfect funnel now. Here comes the Valk Parade. I love how we're just opting to save this troop space. You know, he realized he only needed a few giants. He did not need to use 30 troop space for a golem. So once these Valkyries go in here, they're going to do their thing. Has 2 heal spells, still has a rage spell. So down it goes just to move these Valkyries through right into this heal spell, right? They took huge damage there from the bombs and everything, but healed right back up to full, still standing in the heal for that next bomb. Absolutely perfect. Few hogs sprinkling in on the outside, just taking care of those defenses to keep the Valks up. Heal spell goes down over top of the Teslas, so that's just kind of perfect timing with everything. King standing in there, right? The Teslas are not doing a thing. Queen's now stepping up, joining the party. She's going to start taking care of everything that the Valkyries cannot get to. So just kind of everything just came together absolutely perfectly. Other than this little wall up here, another example of this open alleyway style of base and how it just gets abused, in my opinion, because that queen just walked like right through everything and just picked things off with this Valkyrie army just doing the exact same thing, taking out the alleyway in front of her, and she's just picking off the compartments one by one as she goes. So absolutely sexy read on this, Val. Nice hit, my friend. Welcome to Spec Ops and welcome to Invicta. I don't think I've ever formally said that, so nice job, buddy. Victor, another new member, putting up another tree star here. Brings 10 Valks. I love the heavy Valks. You know, it must have been a cleanup attack because Ops with a 4 Earthquake. So it's going to Earthquake this section. So looking at a few of the bases, you know, it's like any base building. What am I trying to say? Every time in base building, you seem to strengthen one thing, it seems to make another thing weaker. So, for example, a lot of WHF bases kind of were smart in the sense of they had a lot of smaller compartments and very windy, strange compartments. But part of the flaws are you're going to get big value out of earthquakes in certain areas if you're not careful. Like this here, because this earthquake now, yeah, it opens a side compartment, but there's not a lot of places for the Vox to straight. It's almost like a straight line all the way down, basically from the 12 o'clock tip all the way down to like 7-8 o'clock, right at this point right here. So the same idea as I just said on the alleyway bases, if you're just opening up an alleyway for a Val kill squad to core out a pathway and your queen to walk behind them and just mop up the outer compartments from behind, just it's just deadly. Like, you just, that's something you got to think about when you're building your bases, guys. Will an earthquake or will a couple jumps open up too much of my base? And I think in this, a lot of times, right, you don't see it. And like in this example, right, the Valks missed the Tesla farm, but there's just too much dead, right? The queen dies to the Tesla farm. The hogs don't have that much except the Tesla farm to deal with and a heal spell. So down goes the heal and down goes the Teslas. I said down goes the heal. Any seconds. Okay, apparently not. Victor's just swagging the heel, apparently. Like I said, I can't believe he swagged that heel. That was so ballsy. That is ridiculous. Hawks going on a Tesla farm. Crazy. Anyhow, swagged heel, I guess. Just a beautiful tree star, Victor. Very good read on that. All right, Tritosh, another new Spec Ops member. Really been impressed with him over the last, you know, Tritosh isn't as new as some of the other guys I aforementioned, but he's still fairly new. You know, Invicta always has rotating members. We're constantly, you know, pulling guys up or guys leave for whatever reason. So there, you know, we got a lot of movement in our clans, and you know, so we're seeing a lot of new faces, and Tritosh is a guy that's been really solid for us over, I want to say, the last couple months, maybe month to 2 months. Sorry if I'm wrong, but you know, we've been really impressed with him. So we made him an elder actually in Invicta, I believe, and part of our Spec Ops team down there, helping other guys out, plan and all that stuff. So absolutely fantastic. Thank you, Tritosh, for everything you do. And all your sexy tree stars like this one. Jump spell opening up that queen chamber, right? Everything moving in absolutely perfectly. Same idea. Queen's just kind of working in through the base. Going to finish off some of these defenses while the Valks core out this base. The thing about this is when you had this base set up and those two jumps, like I said, when I said the words, the two jumps or an earthquake open up too much of my base, doesn't necessarily mean just in size of your base, it means value of the base. Those two jumps essentially opened up the air defense, so it can just be a good old-fashioned go-vello. And one air defense is remaining over here, but boom, what are these two hogs doing in the bag? Let's just send them in on that last air defense. Going to be no big deal for these balloons that got scattered around the base. It's got no defenses that are going to take care of the queens. Clearly, treat in the bag here for Tritosh. Mm-mm. Beautiful. So let's move up the board, up the chains. Think we had a few bullies in there. Yeah. And bullies are so nerve-wracking. I mean, I'm still fairly new to my Town Hall 10 account. You know, a couple months. I don't even remember. But man, they're nerve-wracking. You got a three-star that. Like, if you miss a bully, it's embarrassing, right? So, I don't know. So, when you nail it, you're like, oh, yes. Like, I find it way, way worse. Because people understand if you screw up and don't get the three-star, you know, Town Hall 9 versus Town Hall 9 or 10 versus 10. But when you're 10 versus 9 and you don't get it, it's never good. Igba, first war in Invicta. Very sexy tree here. Of course, too, Igba. Just so you know, if you want to make recaps, you need to go attacks like this with not a redhead in the pack. Decides to bring a good old Lalo here. Just absolutely brilliant attack here. I like this one. So the idea here is this queen is going to walk into this area and, sorry, opens up the wall and walks kind of down into this area. It gets both these air defenses on this side and essentially clears the 12 to 9 section of the base. She stands in here. I don't remember exactly what happens. I know for sure, though, she gets both air defense, pulls the CC troops out. And then what does that mean, guys? If you have two air defenses down and the CC troops taken care of, all you need to worry about is the defensive queen. So what does he got? Cold-blooded golem goes in here with the king, just basically sends a golem, a king, a couple wizards, right? One wizard, sorry, only has in the bag here for this. Really, that is crazy. So sends, just drops one wizard on the barracks, jumps the king right into the queen, takes care of that action. Here we go. So there goes the CC troops over to the queen there. Raid spell goes down, going to help her out. No big deal. Witch walks right into that poison. Down it goes. Once that goes down, she's going to step up, finish off that air defense. Then here comes the king. He didn't just suit. No, he's got a golem in there yet. So golem goes down. King in behind. Does a little funneling thing with the wizard. King locks onto the army camp. Even drops these two balloons. I thought that was pretty cool. Right on the archer towers. The thing about that is he's just continuing to make sure the king funnels in and getting the defenses at the same time. King goes in. Going to hit that ability and immediately sends in the lava hound. Look at that. Like instant. King locks on. In goes the lava hound. Haste spell goes down. Just really wants to push the loons to help this queen out. They're going to be completely successful. And the rest of the air attack only has basically from 4 o'clock to 2 o'clock to deal with. Boom, rage spell goes down, just a bazillion balloons in there, smashing the remaining defenses. There's not much left to go. Hounds move up to that last air defense. Haste spell goes down, even gonna throw those balloons right on top of the archer tower, finish off this stuff like absolutely nothing. Hound burst, exact perfect moment when the air defense dies. Just a sexy raid, Igba. Then of course, good old fashioned. Last time we faced WHF, they had troll Teslas in the corners too. I wonder if the any bombs revealed. I don't see any bombs revealed. Last war against WHF, I had a 99% two star because the troll Tesla DGB in the corner. So not surprised, guys, to see these corner troll Teslas from an occasional WHF base. MBD, love this guy. In my group, brings a sexy golem avalanche attack. Now, guys, this is why he brought it, the dead zone in the middle. Man, Power Bang didn't say something, because I swear, Power Bang did a video exactly explaining why, especially a exactly centralized dead zone like this, just makes it too easy to predict your base. And the Power Bang's video showed how he broke it down with a Lalo. And it was definitely more exaggerated. This isn't a necessarily bad dead zone. I'm just saying this was the attack to kill it with, to three-star this base with, because you look at how this works, right? So this avalanche attack is basically 5 golems and 4 jumps. Gonna just slowly, it's like the slowest attack in the world. It's like watching paint dry, these attacks. But literally is just gonna feed golems in, kind of 2 at first, and then back up another one. Over here, he's going to drop another one. Over here, he's going to drop another one and just jumps them all into the base. And because of the dead zone, it kind of, because the Tesla's in there, it's not a true dead zone. It throws things off slightly, but it's still the same thing. Once that Tesla goes down, boom, we're going to continue around the ring. So we're just going to keep going around the ring. And because of the dead zone there, you can predict that. And because of that, you can just keep feeding wizards and feeding golems and just take out the base bit by bit by bit. Just the queen has not done almost anything this entire raid. She helped out a little bit and then stood on that wall for the last minute. Just ridiculous. Has to hit the ability. She starts taking out Teslas and stuff. Another jump spell goes down. Still has a jump spell. I believe he's going to drop on maybe this corner up here to let things out. Or maybe just drops it again right there. But whatever. No big deal. Queen goes down. But there's still just so many units. Wizards are backing all of this up. Smashing things, you know, basically one shot, absolutely bit by bit. Like I said, it's like watching paint dry. We're gonna times do this. Scary. This is why it's scary. This is exactly why. Boom, that bomb goes off, and you need to make sure you constantly have wizards in the bag to continue to reinforce on the outside as you lose some as they go inside the base and get hit by traps, etc. Anyhow, tree in the bag for MBD. Nice job, man. Bully. Sort of bully. Oh, yeah, these are... So I guess technically more because these were 11 on... These were only our only two Town Hall 10 3-stars. They were 11s on, I think, 10s, right? 9 was a 10. Yeah. Very new 10, mind you, but still a 10. Inferno Towers are down. So, yeah, you know what? I mean, is what it is, right? WHF, you guys held up over there. Absolutely. Nice job, guys. Always a pleasure to match up with you folks. Nice, fair, clean, fun war. Victor had a lot of fun, and we shall continue. And maybe next time we might even put up a slightly better fight than a 5-star victory. But, you know, like I said, working with the 9s, always the challenge, getting everyone on the same page so the 9s are clearing the 10s, and then the 10s are 2-ing the 11s, and we are just tripling 10s like it's going out of style. That is how she's done. But we're working on it, and we are getting there. A lot of progress in Invicta and 2.0. So a lot of good content coming, guys. And the Cat and I are back on track with the Slay My Base. So I'm really, really, really happy about that because, you know, I know you guys like that content. And going to try and get back on track some cleanup episodes and stuff. So, yeah, good stuff, guys. I'm going to call it a night here. Going to enjoy the rest of my evening now that I'm done work. So to you, I say that does it for your wisdom from Wiser. Just trying to help bag that next tree star. Till then. I'm out.